Hello everyone. Bastet is arguably the best thing that came from Akame ga Kill. The show handled her character really well, not just from design perspective. Simply giving her big boobs would not have gotten her this far. I find it interesting she's the antagonist, not the rival, sometimes foe, sometimes friend, but straight up villain. Okay, maybe the uniform help a bit. I like the uniform. Anime has its fair share of strong female. In fact, Akame ga Kill was built on this premise. But mostly we see them as the protagonists, like the legendary Motoko Kusanagi from Ghost in the Cell. They are easy to root for and easy on the eyes. There is something very appealing and empowering when they can destroy or outsmart the enemies. Anime is usually reluctant to go this route because villain and hero will clash, sooner or later. Which means someone gotta get their ass kicked. Of course, there are ways to avoid this. First, prolong the conflict. Maybe the fights go to a draw, or some plot convenience happens in between, then it drags on. Second, make the villain into friend. Now this can be done properly like Ryuko and Satsuki from Kill la Kill. They have good back and forth chemistry. But that's not how it went down with Asdet. From early on, the series already established that she was an unstoppable force. There is no recruiting or converting her, even if they dangle Tatsumi's ass as a bait. Despite her charming look, Asdet was a legitimate villain. She is sadistic and manipulative, with power and intelligence to take whatever she wanted. And this stemmed from her hard childhood in the wintry northern land. She is committed to the life philosophy of the strong survives and the weak dies. We have seen so many anime try this, but I would argue Akame ga Kill pushed it further than anyone else. It was so ingrained in Asdet to the point that she would use everyone and everything to achieve her goal. There is no long speech from protagonists that's gonna change her mind. In fact, in many points of the story, it was her that made Tatsumi waver using strength and look. She's the next level of femme fatale, the mysterious beautiful lady archetype. Much like in noir movie, the foxy lady trapped her prey with intelligence and seduction. She did it so naturally, perhaps not even intentionally, using mind trick or any other resource to get what she wanted. This might seem cold and appropriate to her ice power. But the beauty of this character is how she seems so normal. As though in different life, she could have been the simple and caring girl. And that's the best con the series ever pulled. Asdet was hardcore psychopath who looked like proper waifu. She committed genocide and war crime throughout the series and had no remorse about it. For her, it's the norm. She even enjoyed causing pain to others, even to civilian and innocent. She got away with all this because her overpowering strength as the most formidable fighter. On top of that, she had charisma to rally others, gathering strong people to her cause. And even if she's a savage, she treated her allies really well when she deemed them worthy. She also had the intelligence and poise to navigate the politics until she had almost understand power in military. Most people in the series idolize her, so she posed a lot of threat to the protagonists. And you know she had to go down, just a matter of time. The series built up to that point, hyping her and her group while not revealing too much of her power. A lot of the things we saw as audience were second source, like from some MC introducing special guests. So there was lingering doubt surrounding her character, whether she's as nasty as they say, or maybe she could be converted into nice girl. Asdet took extreme ownership of her accolade and her wrongdoings. She didn't back away and turn to sob stories. Even with childhood as messed up as hers, she embraced all of her deeds. As far as physical prowess, the series barely showed anything. I much prefer this than say Inuyasha, which at one point was my favorite show. But he fought his stepbrother, Sesshomaru, every week, like it's family brunch. We only saw bits of Asdet power until the very end, where it's really do or die. And there's effective emotional weight to her showdown. The way both Akame and Esdet were so calm, how they pushed themselves to the brink. We knew the series didn't shy away from killing character, and the anticipation really made the final fight. Akame ga Kill had ups and downs, but for what it's worth, it delivered one of the best villains in anime. Her infamy will live on, outlasting the image of her big breasts in uniform. Well, maybe people will remember the big boobs part more, but still good character. And that's it. Thank you for watching. Please drop a like and comment below. Consider subscribing and share with your friends. I make 3 videos every week. Have a nice day, and I'll see you in the next one.